The fast case MRAS bot runs every month and consolidates an archive of all vendors and their contract information in e-library with the active vendors in Qualtrics and a verification table. Right here, we see the verification table, and we've just made some edits to verify a few contacts as no that had been previously deleted from Qualtrics. We can see that there's a tab for the already verified no contacts, the unsubscribed contacts, and contracts that have expired. Now we're going to start running the bot. And so it's going to open Qualtrics and download the current directory. It is going to compare all of the contacts with those in an input e-library archive, and it's going to perform a number of filtering features. For example, if any contact has been updated in Qualtrics, it's going to be put into the verification table. If any contact has been deleted from Qualtrics, it will be put in the verification table. New contacts in e-library will be added so long as they match certain fields for contacts with the same email. A number of filtering steps are taken. So right now it's just downloading the current Qualtrics directory. Here we've skipped around a bit because certain processes, such as downloading the directory, take a while. This video actually skips around 7 minutes of filtering, as there are tens of thousands of contacts that need to be cross-referenced and sorted in specific ways. But so now the filtering's all done, and the bot has produced a list of all the contacts that should be reflected in the Qualtrics directory, as well as ones that need to be deleted. So right now it's searching for all contacts who, for example, their contracts have expired, or they have unsubscribed, or some other criteria as specified in the business requirements that would demand that contact be deleted. So those contacts have all been searched and deleted. And now the bot is going to upload a list of the new contacts that need to be added or updated. So it will begin that in 1 second. And here it's adding those contacts. The bot should already have made edits to the verification tables in the shared Google Drive. An archive of the updated directory and the current verification table is stored in a shared Google Drive that the bot accesses every run. So now the bot's checking to see if there are any new lists, SIN lists, associated with any of contacts that are being added. And if there are certain lists that need to be added to Qualtrics or filters to create lists for a new SIN, then the bot will add that automatic list enrollment rule. This run, there were no new SINs, and so the bot just skipped that process. Now the bot's finished, and we can check to see the updated Qualtrics directory archive put in the 2020 November folder in the shared Google Drive, and you can see that this archive has exactly as many contacts in here as there are now currently in Qualtrics. And now we can go into the verification folder. We can see a number of the contacts in e-library were missing an email or SIN value. That's why those columns are highlighted. And so those are put into the verification table. We have the updated verified no, the updated unsubscribed, and the updated contract expired. And you can see that this expiration date is earlier than the date of the run. It is for October 2020, and so those contacts have all been deleted.